Hello people, let's see in this video how to apply advanced effects and transitions with CyberLink PowerDirector 14. If you have problems with the accent, enable our closed captions clicking on the CC icon in the bottom right corner. In the previous videos of this guide, we have seen how to edit and adjust your clips, such as their basic properties through the title designer and the PIP designer, the adjustments inside Fix and Enhance, and the power tools inside the Tools button. PowerDirector 14 gives you also the possibility to apply advanced effects and transitions. Let's see the effects. These are more advanced than the power tools seen already, since these may change the way to show and see your clips. All these advanced effects are listed inside the effect room. All these advanced effects can be applied on any visible clip, such as image clips, video clips, and text clips. Click on one to select it and check it through the preview on the right. Then, simply drag and drop it on a visible clip. This will get an orange eye letter in a corner, indicating that the effect is applied on such clip. If you don't like the effect applied, simply use Ctrl and Z to undo. When you select a clip with advanced effects inside, a new button called Effect appears. If you click on it, you will open the Effect panel, used to manage all advanced effects applied on such clip. This lists all effects on the clip on the list on the left. Check and uncheck these to enable or disable them. Below such list, you have three buttons. The first two are used to move up or down the selected effect inside the list, to change the order followed when applying the effects on the clip. When this order changes, the overall effect on the clip may change. The minus button, instead, is used to remove the selected effect from the list. You can change the settings of the selected effect more on the right. Plus, you can also change these effects in time going to the keyframe button. In this panel, when you apply advanced effects on the clip, a new section called Effect appears in the list on the left. If you want to know more about the keyframes, check out our previous videos in this guide. In case you want to apply the same advanced effects on more than a single clip, you can use the effect track. This welcomes advanced effects that you can drag and drop directly from the effect room. This creates an effect clip with the same name of the effect imported, that can be managed as normal clips. This effect clip affects all clips that fall in the same instant of time and are on an upper track respect to the effect track. In this way, you can choose all clips to apply the effect on and manage the order of the tracks to choose which clips must not be affected. Let's see now the transitions. These are available for both visible clips and audio clips. Transitions are special effects that are used to introduce or exit from a clip in playback with special effects. All transitions are inside the transition room. When you select one, you can check the preview to see how the transition goes from the clip A to the following clip B. To add one, drag and drop it on the interested clip on one of its extreme edges. The transition added on the clip will be represented through its icon. You can change the kind of transition simply dragging and dropping another one from the transition room. To change the duration of the transition, instead, drag the edges of its icon on the clip. If you double-click on it, you can adjust its duration precisely and eventually change its settings. To remove the transition, right-click on its icon and go to Remove. Transitions can be applied also between two independent clips on the timeline. Just overlap such clips and choose Crossfade to apply a simple fade transition between those, indicated by a red dashed contour. Then just click and drag a transition from the transition room to the crossfade. This transition can be edited and removed as seen for single clips. There are transitions available for sound waveforms that you can recognize through a sound icon in the bottom right corner. These can be applied on video or sound clips, and these do change volume in time. Thanks for watching. Check out our YouTube channel to discover more.